This is One-on-One. Sivaraman Anbarasan is Executive Director of New Jersey Community College Consortium for Workforce and Economic Development. Good to see you.
Glad to be here.
You join us on our sister program, Caucus New Jersey, talking about a lot of these issues. By the way, this consortium that we're talking about, who's involved in the consortium and who benefits from it?
Yeah, this consortium consists of all the 19 community colleges of New Jersey. The colleges are involved in workforce development activities in addition to college credit courses and programs that you're all familiar with. So the local businesses and the local citizens benefit from all the programs that we do from the statewide perspective.
When you say the programs you do, you're really trying to help people who are struggling right now in terms of employment gain skills and tools, right?
Yeah.
So give us an example. How does that work?
Sure. There are two areas that we help the businesses and the people of New Jersey. One is training incumbent employees, close the skills gap. Department of Labor provides us a lot of funding to do that. That's one segment of it. Large piece of our work goes in that area. The second is more important, but it's a smaller area where we help unemployed people get back into gainful employment. And we feel very good about the programs that we have. All these programs are delivered through community colleges in your area. So they are very local, very specific, designed to meet the needs of the employers in the area.
You talk about certain areas, and you're very customized. Talk about Atlantic City and the fact that so many casinos have closed, thousands of people have lost their jobs. What are you doing down there?
We just had an initial meeting. Department of Labor just received $29 million national emergency grant from the feds. So we just had a planning meeting last week. We are looking at several industries, several companies that are willing to partner with us. So we have to design training programs to meet those open jobs.
What do they need?
Well, the statistics or the jobs, real-time jobs, show that there's a need for healthcare, allied healthcare folks in that area. Construction workers, there's a demand for that. And professional services, accountants, engineers, those kind of jobs are available.
You also have this mobile classroom. I read about that, and I'm thinking, where is this mobile classroom going, and how do people access it?
Yes, that's a very successful program that we initiated about a year ago. This is specifically addressing the needs of manufacturing companies in New Jersey. As you know, New Jersey is a huge manufacturing base. There are lots of small manufacturers. These are not very big ones, 25, 50 people companies, and they have a real tough time recruiting and retaining qualified technicians. Only four colleges in New Jersey have the infrastructure to train and prepare this workforce. So we received a grant from the federal government to create mobile training labs with CNC machines, which is what needed in many of these manufacturing companies. So we take these trailers to different areas where manufacturing companies are looking for entry-level technicians, CNC operators.
What does CNC mean?
Computerized numerical control.
Okay.
It's a mechanized way of machining. Metal fabrication business needs that skill set.
So hold on. When people graduate from the program, how do you track their success in terms of finding employment?
It's a very good question. The way that we do this training is a flipped model. We do the training we work with the employers before we do the training. We know who the employers are that are requiring skilled laborers.
And you find out what they need?
We find out before we begin the training program. So we then bring them into our college. We bring the unemployed people, we have them meet, and we select the people that are suitable to work in this shop. And then we do the training. It could be about 12-week training. We teach the basics of manufacturing, machining. So then employers are constantly involved in the during the training, And at the end, 90% of the people get jobs.
90%
get jobs.
Across the board in different industries?
Well, we have tried this in the manufacturing industry so far, and we are going to extend the same model into information technology and life sciences through a $10 million grant we just received to help the long-term unemployed.
Before I let you add, I'm curious, in the manufacturing side, we're doing well?
We're doing very well.
Why is that? I've heard so many things about how we're struggling on the manufacturing side.
Well, that might be the case, but the New Jersey manufacturers are very niche manufacturing companies. What they do is make components that go into bigger things.
For example?
For example, we have a component manufacturer that makes components that go into radars.
So, and there's a niche for that. There's a market
there
for that.
There is a very special market. And there's another manufacturer who fixes elevators throughout the country. And these are, you know, he cannot fill the job orders that he has because the demand is so much. Mm. And these are very special niche manufacturing companies. And they have this need, and they cannot find reliable, trained workforce. And that's where we come in and help
it's
them.
It's called the New Jersey Community College Consortium for Workforce and Economic Development. And thank you for joining us and sharing your perspective on this very important issue. Keep doing what you're doing. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Glad to be here.
This is One-on-One. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation, celebrating over 25 years of broadcast excellence. Funding for this edition of One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been provided by Investors Bank, Choose New Jersey, United Airlines, the Northward Center, NJIT, Fedway Associates, and by Community Food Bank of New Jersey. Transportation provided by Airbrook Limousine, serving the metropolitan New York, New Jersey area.